There are 3 easy steps in creating your resume link. Let me show you how.
Step 1. Register. Go to www.jobs180.com using any browser and click Register Now. Fill out all the information needed. In choosing your resume link, use your full name so that it looks professional and it's easy to recall by potential employers. For example, Antonio Juan de la Cruz at jobs180.com. Step 2. Create and design. When creating your resume, make sure to complete your personal information and upload your profile picture. One of the highlights of the resume link is the portfolio section. In the portfolio section, you can show off your skills by uploading samples of your work like documents, pictures, videos, and your social media links.
Your resume link also features different themes and you can upload a cover photo. This is a combination of a cover letter and a social network cover photo. Here is an example. You can also download a copy of your resume link and print it. Step 3. Apply for a job. There are many ways to apply with your resume link.
First is browsing the job recommendations in your Jobs 180 dashboard.
If you're qualified, click Submit Resume Link. So what are you waiting for? Dress up your next generation resume, stand out brightly among the competitive job seekers in the market, and win the heart of your future employers using Resume Link.
In this constantly changing world where businesses move at a rapid pace, Innodata solves the toughest challenges in any industry. Through human expertise and the power of technology, we are a community that thrives on a culture of collaboration, ideation, and innovation. And we want you to be part of our family. Your journey towards a meaningful and thriving career begins with us. Be part of the Inno community. We are Inno Data.
In Makati Medical Center, your well-being does not stop. We promote a healthy normal by complying with 100% safety protocols in our facilities. With world-class service and operational excellence, we ensure that Makati Med meets the global healthcare standards of JCI. No matter the nature of your visit, your health is our priority. So you are always safe in Makati Med, the hospital with a heart.
At a time when customers are demanding more value more rapidly, you need a transformation partner that can help make your customer experience your competitive differentiator. For years, RRD Go has been helping companies reinvent how they do business and reimagine how customers connect with their brand. Our customized solutions, deep industry expertise, and highly skilled global talent pool empower clients across every industry. We elevate customer engagement with targeted, interactive, and compelling omni-channel communications, and leverage tech-driven solutions to reimagine customer interactions and accelerate your transformation agenda. Our digital and workflow solutions generate actionable insights, enhance organizational flexibility, and simplify transactions. We harness the power of next-level technologies to bring new solutions to life. Everything from automation and data visualization to AI, AR, and beyond. By combining best-in-class, forward-looking technologies with some of the industry's best forward-thinking minds, we can help take your customer experience beyond what you thought was possible. Discover how. Visit rrd.com/go today.
Ever notice how a smile is contagious? It's hard not to smile when someone's smiling at you. Go ahead, try it. We'll wait. Smiling yet? Us too. Here at TTEC, we love smiles. In fact, we've built a culture around them and a brand on top of them. For us, it's all about the feeling you get when someone goes that extra smile to brighten your day. It's how an upside-down frown makes our TTEC world go round. Our mission is to make the whole world smile, and it starts with you. We focus on what matters most to you. Career growth, personal development, well-being, whatever it may be. It's all part of the TTEC experience. So put on a smile. Come join us and let's change the world, one smile at a time.
All right, so good morning, everybody, and welcome to JobZone80.com's 2024 Marketing Me Live with Arellano University All Campus. So today, we will be joined by speakers from Kooapps, Wells Fargo, and of course, JobZone80.com. So before we start, may we invite everybody for the opening prayer to be followed by the singing of our national anthem.
Let us bow our heads to acknowledge the holiness of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Almighty God and Heavenly Father, thank you for giving us a new day. Despite the difficulties we encounter daily, we praise and thank you for all the blessings you are pouring out to each of us. We are truly grateful for this wonderful opportunity to gather here today to have this kind of activity in our university. We know that we Without your blessings, we would not be able to succeed with our plans, particularly for this event. Bestow your grace and divine wisdom to all of us as we fulfill our purpose in the spirit of love and generosity. May you continually bless each one of us, our families, our loved ones, and the university as our place of labor and dedication. May you guide and be with us as we truly believe and pray in your mighty name. All of this we ask in Jesus' name.
Good morning, Arellano University. So is everyone ready for today's event? So I hope you all are. And di ko talaga maiwasan maging energetic kasi it's Monday and Monday is a new day. So by the way, I am your host, Yumiap Abu, and I am from jobzone80.com. And we are live again via jobzone80.com Facebook and jobzone80.com YouTube. So we hope that everybody is as excited as I am to listen and learn new things today. So to officially start today's session, let us welcome Ms. Mildred C. Pangyan, the RGC, RPM, and Supervising Guidance Counselor of Arellano University, Juan Sumulong Campus, to give us the opening remarks.
To our source speakers and facilitators from jobs180.com, fellow guidance counselors, especially to our dear students, good morning and welcome to our Marketing Me pre-employment webinar. As a soon-to-be graduate, you are about to face another chapter of your life. After many years of being a student, you will now be called professionals. You are about to face your new world, the world of work. Sounds exciting, right? But the reality when seeking for a job is that the world of work is highly competitive. With this, you may start asking yourself on how prepared are you in applying for a job, knowing that your competitors are more experienced, knowledgeable, and skilled than you. You are so eager to know how and where to catch that very first great opportunity. Landing your first job is really an exciting and challenging time in any professional's career. It is a challenge, but also an opportunity to learn and grow. Your first job is a chance to start building your professional network. This network will help you move forward in your career, so it's important to make connections and build relationships from the very start. You will also be able to learn new skills and knowledge that will help you in your future career goals. There may be some challenges, bumps, and struggles along the way, but these are all part of the learning process. Your first job is actually the beginning of your career. This means that planning ahead to equip yourself with all the skills and knowledge on how you are going to sell yourself to your prospective companies is very essential. So, how can you make yourself more appealing to potential employers? What are you going to do to make your application an eye-catcher and to showcase your qualifications? How prepared are you to present yourself during interview and make a positive impression? This is the reason why we are conducting this kind of webinar today, to help you dear students to be equipped with the basics of employment application and how to maximize your chances of getting hired. So, prepare yourself to learn and be inspired from our resource speakers and hopefully to apply all the things you will learn today for your future job hunting. Our dear students, always remember that no matter how difficult it is, no matter how many rejections, failures, and challenging interviews you will go through, don't give up. Never lose hope, because there will always be a company out there or an employer who will recognize your potentials and willing to give you the biggest opportunity in your career. Just believe in yourself. Be confident and trust the process. And when that great opportunity comes in, do your best to showcase your capabilities to contribute and grow professionally and be an asset to them. Learn from the people you work with, stay positive, focus, and enjoy every experience you make, and never stop pursuing your ultimate career goals. So, good luck and congratulations in advance. Once again, good morning to everyone.
All right. So thank you so much, Miss Mildred, for that very wonderful and heartwarming remarks, no? So there you have it, guys. So main theme talaga natin in adulthood is challenges once we graduate from college. So remember what Ma'am Mildred said. Don't give up, never lose hope, and always, always try again. So for our audience today, please comment your campus, name, year, and course. And if you have questions later on, please post them in the comment section and we will answer them in the talk. So the question and answer portion will happen after each speaker's presentation. So don't forget to tag and share this to your friends na rin, especially those who are not yet here. So mention them in the comment section. So before we proceed to the first speaker, I have a bit of an ad for you. So have you been manifesting to reach your hashtag career goals for this 2024? So don't worry, because in Accenture, we got you. So join our one-day hiring event on April 17, 2024 and be part of our amazing data entry and accounting teams here at Accenture. So just scan the QR code presented in your screen, or you can visit the link below. So what are you waiting for? So scan the QR code and be part of Accenture, where we work at the heart of change. Okay, there you have it. So here is our schedule for today. So job applications using ResumeLink by jobs180.com, after graduation checklist by Kooapps, and virtual interview tips by Wells Fargo. So now we have very great topics for today, and I bet everyone is excited and ready to listen to our speakers for today. So shout out to everyone who is already here na, and for those classmates and schoolmates who are not yet here, tell them to come and watch our webinar, because we will sure be learning lots of things that we are going to need when we enter the world of work. So don't forget to comment your name, year, and of course, your course. And as we go along, type in your questions so we can read it later. So sabi nga ni Susan Rosas, wag mahihiyang magtanong. So this is your chance to ask before you face the world of work. All right, so to our audience, sit back, relax, and let us all hashtag learn together as I introduce to you our first speaker. So our first speaker will be discussing job applications using ResumeLink. So he has 20 years of experience in sales, marketing, business development, customer service, operations, business process, and human resources. So as a trusted resource speaker, he has done over 1,000 career development seminars in more than 400 colleges and universities nationwide. So let us all welcome the managing director of JobZone80.com, Mr. Kim Chua. Sir Kim, take it away.
Everyone, good day to all of you. My name is Kim, Kim Chua. Don't forget the wa, baka Kim Chua lang maalala nyo. And I'm here to share to you about the most secured tool for job application. This is how you can market yourself more effectively and the different ways to do that. Okay, so let me start. Now, when you apply, you probably have a checklist if you're using the right tool. So just go along with me if you have the right, if you have the same checklist that I have. So ito yung mga things na like kung tinatandaan, no? Will my tool or will the thing that I'll be using help me to stand out? That's the first item that is very important for me. Kailangan mag-stand out ako kasi dami-dami kong kasabayan kalaban sa pag-apply. Another thing in my checklist is that, do I have more than one file? Because oftentimes, I have a lot of files. May academic records, may mga government IDs, and dami yung mga kailangan hingiin ng mga companies. So I'd like to put them all in one file. And this tool helps me to do that. Okay? Another thing that this tool can do is that it allows me to make the process more efficient. Mas napapabilis yung pag-apply. No? Hindi na napapatagal yung pabalik-balik. So mas mabilis din syempre tayo maka-move forward. Oh, diba? And another thing that this tool can do is that wala tong bayad. Oh, mukha lang akong salesman pero libre po ito. Okay? So this tool is absolutely for free. The most important in my checklist is that this tool, okay, makes my information secured. And I think this is the most important question. Do you want your information to be secured? I hope your answer is yes. Okay? And so with that, let me show you ano tong tool na ito. This tool is called ResumeLink. ResumeLink, by definition, is the most secured tool for job application. Okay? This is a personalized URL. It is a link that anyone can open online anytime, provided that they know the link. So let me use an example. If you are John Santos, just in case lang, your name is John Santos, your resume link would look something like johnsantos.jobs180.com. Ganun lang kasimple. So how do you make one? Okay, how do you make one? Now, the first step is for you to register. This is absolutely for free. Wala itong bayad. Okay? So what do you do? You go to www.jobs180.com and that is where you now register. Okay? As you register, you just simply fill out the information. These are the basic information. You have the account details. You have your personal information. You have your education background. And just in case you have your work experience, whether it's OJT or it's part-time job or whatever yung work experience ayan, then you proceed to that work experience page. Pero pag wala, hanggang dyan na lang tayo sa may education information. Okay? After doing so, you now start to create your resume link. So ano ba ang basihan ng resume link? Kadalasan, ang resume link natin, we base it on our name. We base it on our unique name. Okay? So as an example, if you are John Santos, then you say johnsantos.jobs180.com. Now, what about during scenarios where you create your resume link tapos may nauna sa inyo, may ibang John Santos, may kapangalan ka, no, nauna sa inyo. Ano mangyayari? Magkakaroon na red na box, sasabihin niya, this name has already been taken. Na okay, malungkot pag taken na. Okay lang, maging creative lang kayo ng konti. Pwede mo balik na rin. Pwede mo sabihin Santos John. Okay, you can also say Santos J. O kaya J Santos. O kaya JS, di ba? Or SJ. Depende sa link na gusto mo gawin. Basta importante, wala kang kapareho kahit kayo may kapangalan. Now, another thing I'd like to emphasize here, huwag po kayong OA. Pag gumawa kayo ng resume link, huwag mo gagawin tipong nakalagay cutie pie, lover boy, Barbie doll, di ba? Because it doesn't sound professional. Imagine going to a company and the HR will ask you, do you have your resume? Tapos sasabihin mo sa kanya, meron po, ang resume ko ay eljablo.jobsonidiot.com. Di ba? Baka matakot yung HR sa inyo. So I don't recommend that you do something like that. Just stick to your name. Whatever your name is, it will sound professional. Okay? Now, in creating a resume link, you have to use a valid email. Emails like Yahoo, Gmail, Rocketmail, any email, basta nabubuksan nyo, wag na wag ka lang gagamit ng facebook.com na email. Okay? Do not use something like, example lang ha, patrick@facebook.com na email. Do not use patricia@facebook.com na email. Okay? In short, do not use @facebook.com na email. Because if you use @facebook.com, you will no longer be able to receive notifications being sent to you by the companies as well as jobs180.com. Okay? So use something that you can open. Why is it important for you to open your email? Because you have to verify your account. Okay? Remember, yeah, pag nag-verify, yan ang ebidensya na ikaw nag-register talaga. Yan ang proof. Diba? And at the same time, if you verify your account, then you'll be receiving notifications from the companies as well as jobs on AT. If you do not verify your account, hindi nyo na po marireceive yung mga notification ng mga companies. So, sayang naman, di ba? Might as well verify your account first. Okay? Now, you're done with the first step after you verify. So, ano na ang second step? Ang second step is the most logical of all the step. You have to complete all the information. Very logical. Sino sa inyo mag-apply sa mga kumpanya bungi-bungi detalye? Sino sa inyo magbibigay ng resume sa mga HR tapos kulang-kulang details nyo? I don't think you'll do that because you're just wasting your time. Instead, kumpletuhin yung information nyo bago kayo mag-submit dun sa mga companies. Okay? So, step two, complete the information. And how do you do that? Punta kayo ulit dun sa website, www.jobs110.com. And this time, you don't need to register again kasi may account ka na eh. What you need to do is you have to log in. Okay? Now, as you log in, you start to put your registered email or your resume link and then your password. Na ikaw lang may alam. Okay? Ganun lang siya kasimple. Now, once you're inside your account, you start to fill in the blanks. Ganun lang kasimple. Fill in the blanks. So, the things that you see here, yung mga contents, napakasimple lang. Yung mga personal details nyo, lagay mo dyan. Diba? All the information that's tingin nyo relevant, you put it there. Now, I have some emphasis lang on items na madalas nami-miss out ito ng mga aplikante. Ano yung mga yon? Sa contact information, you have to put here all the possible ways na pwede kang makontakt ng isang HR. Kagaya ng social media handles nyo. Ba't ko nasabi yan? Because in reality is, pag tinatawagan kayo ng mga HR, madalas hindi naman ina-answer eh. Lalo na pag hindi nyo kilala, pag nag-ring yung phone nyo, hala, sino kaya ito? Diba, hindi mo kilala. Ano gagawin? Hahayaan mo na lang. Diba, antay mo kung may mag-message sa inyo. Eh, paano kung yung HR hindi naman masipag hindi masipag mag-message? Masipag lang siya magtawag. That's why I recommend you put here all the possible means na pwede kang makontakt, kagaya ng social media nyo. Put your Facebook there, yung mga messenger nyo, mga Twitter nyo, iba pang mga paraan, social media handles, para mabilis kayo ma-reach out. Diba? Message-message na lang. Are you available Thursday, 10 a.m., so on and so forth. You get what I'm saying? Diba? So lahat ng paraan, lagay mo dyan. What else do you put here? You also put here yung inyong mga work options. So work options naman, you just choose lang, parang yes or no lang yan, parang switch, no? Kung ano yung mga options na gusto ninyo. No, willing to work night shift, willing to relocate, looking for OJT, you can also put it here. Okay? And then in terms of education, obvious naman, edi yung alma mater nyo, lagay nyo dito. Diba? Yung mga pampakapal ng resume, sa seminars attended, kahit magkopyahan pa kayo ng mga classmates mo, okay lang. Basta lang make sure, alam nyo na pag-usapan doon sa seminar na yon. Pagdating sa certification, ganun din yan. Walang limit sa space yan. Achievements, recommend ko dito is you don't only put yung mga achievement nyo inside the school. Okay? Kasi hindi naman lahat tayo academically inclined. Some of us are not very active sa school, pero active tayo sa mga social civic organization. Diba? So, even if it's outside of the school, you can also put it there. As long as you think it is an achievement, you put it there. Okay? Now, in terms of skills and languages, isa-isain ko lang yan, ha? Sa skills, do not limit your skills dyan lang sa course nyo. Hindi perkat education ng course mo, ang ibig sabihin, ang skills na alam mo lang ay magturo. Hindi perkat accounting ang course mo, ang alam mo lang gawin or ang skills mo ay mag-debit, credit, at mag-balance sheet. Diba? So, marami kang alam na iba pa mga skills na kahit walang connect sa course, you can also put it here. Sample, photography, diba? Videography, diba? And all the other things, calligraphy, pwede mo ilagay dyan. Okay? When it comes to languages, I'm sure alam nyo dalawang lengguwahe na at the minimum. You know English and you know Filipino. If you know local dialect, to be specific, lagay mo Tagalog, Chabacano, Bisaya, Kapampangan, diba? Ilonggo, wala naman limit sa space eh. Diba? If you know foreign languages, put it there. Chinese, Japanese, French, Vietnamese, kung ano man yan, ilagay nyo. Because what you're doing is you're trying to market yourself more effectively to the prospective company. Now, when it comes to references, sigurado naman ako yung mga references nyo, kilala nyo. Ang tanong lang dyan, kayo ba kilala nila? Kasi madalas pag tinatawagan namin yung mga references nyo, hindi kayo maalala. Yung pinakamalupit dyan, hindi talaga kayo kilala. Okay, so please advise yung mga references nyo na ginawa nyo silang reference para at least they know what to tell about you. Okay? Now, at this point, I'd like to highlight yung mga things that you don't find in a traditional resume. Ano yung mga yan? Diba? Ito yung mga yun. Let me start with the portfolio section. The portfolio section is where you now upload evidence of your skills. And I think with this day and age, dito pumapasok yung efficiency, no, ng ating application sa mga companies. Because oftentimes, when we apply to companies, marami mga hinihingi, mga pre-employment requirements. They will ask for mga documents, mga proof that is showing na yan talaga yung mga skills nyo. So, kung ano man meron yung mga documents, you can now take a picture, you can scan them, and you can upload it here. Example, government IDs. Diba? Meron ka mga transcripts, academic records. diba, you can put that there. Okay, kung mayroong mga medical clearance na kailangan, ganun din. Hindi na kailangan magpabalik-balik sa company. Oh, ayos ba? Oh, ito pa. Ba? But wait, there's more. Ito na yun. Itong isa pang gusto ko i-recommend sa inyo, yung tinatawag natin selfie video. Nowadays, I think, it is not very difficult to create a selfie video. Diba? Ito may TikTok nga kayo eh. Diba? Alam mo naman paano gumawa ng selfie video. So I don't need to teach you how to create a selfie video. What I need to share to you na lang is yung anong kailangan sabihin pagka gumawa ka ng selfie video. Okay, this time, what I recommend is you say something interesting about yourself. Okay? So, you pretend that you're being interviewed by the HR. Diba? Ano yung matatanong sa atin? Why should we hire you? Diba? Tell me something about yourself. Why should we consider you among all the other applicants? O, di ba? Ang kagandahan ngayon is, you create that video for about 1 minute or less. Hindi kailangan sobrang haba, no? Mga 1 minute lang or less. Pero ang maganda rito is, na-evaluate na nung HR yung inyong communication skills. If you can speak in English, then I recommend you speak in straight English. But if you cannot, it's okay as long as you're able to show your personality. You can also showcase here yung mga hard skills nyo. Ano yung mga hard skills? Kagaya ng mga video na panood ko dati, pinakita nila how to use a soldering iron, how to properly handle a welding machine, diba? How to fold table napkins. O, ganun, diba? So depende kung ano yung mga skills na alam mo at depende kung ano yung nasa field mo rin, 'di ba, na napag-aralan, 'di ba? So, gusto mo magpakita ka paano mag-balance sheet, pwede rin, 'di ba? Again, it really depends on what you wanted to show dun sa HR. Ang point is, you don't need to travel back and forth para lang ipakita on the spot dun sa HR yung inyong hard skills. And most importantly, hindi na kailangan magkaroon ng maraming aberya, maraming istorbo, 'di ba? Sometimes when we try to contact you for the phone interview, maingay yung background, hindi marinig, 'di ba? Mahina signal, maingay, ano nangyari? Nasa biyahe. Diba? Or sometimes, hindi magtugma yung schedule. At least with that selfie video, it makes the process now more efficient. Now, another good thing pa with the resume link is that you also upload here your profile picture. When it comes to profile picture, you don't need to go to the studio para magpa-picture. Kailangan gumastos. Ang importante lang dyan, tumingin ka sa camera, okay, with plain background. At of course, magbihis ka naman ng maayos. Diba? And then, you're good to go. Huwag mo gagawin yung mga nasa right side ng screen niyo. Those samples that I'm showing you, it doesn't look professional. Imagine, di ba, yung mga selfie-selfie, mga nilagay ng avatar, yan, hindi, huwag nyo gawin yan. Okay? Huwag nyo gawin yan. It doesn't look nice. Doesn't look professional. Okay? Now, another good thing pa with the resume link is that meron tayong tinatawag na cover photo. Ayan, pasintabi sa matatamaan. May iba sa inyo nakikinig ngayon, hindi naman kayo gifted with writing skills. Some of us are having a difficult time expressing our thoughts and feelings into words. So ano pwede mo gawin? You can now use those pictures to represent your personality or to showcase yung inyong skills. Example, look at the one on the left, yung nasa baba. Ano kaya siya? Sabi ni iba, sir, ophthalmologist, optometrist, or eye expert. Yung nasa kanan, yung nasa taas, ano kaya siya? Sabi ni iba, sir, para siyang admin or clerical work. Or maybe makalat, kasi tingnan mo yung lamesa, ang kalat-kalat. O, diba? Again, it depends on the interpretation of the person looking at it. This is an example of someone into HR or maybe into psychology. And this one is an example, it's a very good example, by the way, of someone who wanted to say that there is no shortcut to success. Hindi po yan miyembro na akit bahay gang. Okay? Ang gusto niya sabihin, you will be able to reach yung goal mo by taking one step at a time. Oh, di ba? You get what I'm saying now. So I'm showing you good examples para you can draw inspiration from. And I will also show you not so good examples. Ito yung huwag niyong gagayahin. Huwag kayong magpapakamisteryoso. Okay? Maglagay ka ng picture mo dyan. Lalaki man, babae, in between, okay lang. Ilagay mo dyan. Member man tayo ng LGBTQ+, okay lang. You put it there. At least alam ng HR who to expect. A lot of times, yung mga pangalan kasi very interchangeable nowadays. Ako mismo, guilty ako dyan. My name is Kim. A lot of people think, babae ako, di ba? Eh, pag iba, nababasa ko mga resume, ano nakalagay sa resume nila? Chris, nakalagay George, Alex, Sam, Nick, di ba? Joey. I would assume lalaki. Yun pala, babae. O, di ba? So that's why you better make sure you put your picture there. And wag naman pugot yung ulo nyo pag nalagay ng picture. Dapat kompleto. Okay? Never leave this blank because if you leave this blank, it will not catch the HR's attention. Trust me. Kung ikaw ang HR, wala ka namang ibang makita dyan, malamang mangyayari dito, next applicant na. Okay? And then if you want to catch the HR's attention, do not create something like this. This is just my opinion. I don't think this looks professional kasi ang dating parang tamad, parang happy-go-lucky, no? Parang chill-chill, walang pakialam sa buhay. Again, that is just my interpretation. Okay? So I showed you the good and not so good examples para you'll be guided. Now, you can just play along later on kung anong sa tingin nyo mas bagay sa inyong background or sa inyong sa gusto niyo ipakita sa personality niyo. Okay? Now let's examine a very good example. Look at this person, itong iExpert. Bakit maganda itong example ng kanyang resume link? Because all the information you're seeing here, kompleto na. 'Di ba? Hindi kina magpabalik-balik eh. Kung ikaw yung HR, everything that you need to ask or you want to know about the applicant, you already find it here. If you're the HR, if you're the applicant, you might as well put everything there para wag mo na antayin pa yung time na hihingiin pa sa inyo ng HR yung mga documents yan. Baka hindi na mangyari yun. Baka may ibang aplikante na mas assertive, nilagay lahat ng mga information, na i-process na siya kaagad. Diba? Now, at this point, I know what you're thinking. You're probably thinking, sir, okay nga tong resume link. Kaso lang, baka naman yung information ko nakakalat na sa buong mundo. Baka naman nakalantad na sa buong internet. Ang sagot ay, hindi! Kaya nga ta tinawag na the most secure tool for your job application. Diba? Bakit? Because you control your privacy settings. Ikaw mismo, as an account user or as a resume link owner, ikaw ang may control ng privacy settings mo. And how will that happen? When you log into your dashboard, as you can see in my screen, when you log into your dashboard, you will find the resume link settings. Pagpunta mo sa settings, mapuntahan mo yung privacy settings at dun ka mamili ngayon ng information you want to show or hide in public. So let me use an example. If you don't want to show your birthday, what do? You turn it off. You don't want to show your references, you turn it off. You don't want to show your address, what do? Turn it off. Diba? So yung mga information na in-off mo, hindi lalabas sa public. Now, if ever lang you decide to change your mind, ang maganda dito sa resume link, updated yan, real time. As in real time. So 5 minutes later, you want to show your birthday, turn it on, what happens? Lahat ng mayroong alam ng resume link mo, alam na niya yung birthday mo. Diba? If 2 days later, you want to show your address, you turn it on, you save your profile, lahat ng may alam ng resume link mo, alam na rin yung inyong address. You get what I'm saying? Diba? So, depende na sa inyo kung ano gusto mo i-on or i-off. If you want to turn off everything, then okay lang, you can just turn off the button. Enable public resume link, off. Wala nang lalabas sa public, kahit na anong information. Okay? So, yan ang re-remind ko sa inyo. This, the second step is for you to complete the information, and in doing so, please make sure that your profile is interesting, diba, yung information mo kompleto at updated ang details nyo para mabilis kayo makontakt ng mga HR. Now, we go to the last step. Pangatlo na, last step na to. The last step is for you to submit. Now, how will you submit your resume link to those companies? You might be thinking, you want to explore opportunities outside of the Philippines. Maybe you want to join some job fairs later on. You want to apply online. You want to, marami, walk-ins, diba? Depende kung ano, kasi bumabalik na yung face-to-face ngayon. So, lahat ng mga ipapakita ko sa inyo, lahat ito, practical application. Lahat yan, makaka-relate kayo. Ano yung first one? The first one is you go online. Of course. Diba? Yan ang fastest way. You just connect via your phone, via kung ano man gadget mo, go to jobson80.com, search for companies. And by the way, speaking of search, you can only search for company, tatlo lang pwede mo i-search, ha? Search for company name, position title, and location. Doon sa search bar, hindi mo pwede ma-search ang resume link. So example lang, ikaw si John Santos, okay? Okay, ikaw si, ako na lang, Kim, halimbawa lang, subukan mo pumunta sa jobson80.com, dun sa search bar, type mo dun, Kim. Tingnan mo kung may lumabas. Malamang sa malamang, walang lalabas. Unless, ha, may company name, position title, or location na may word na Kim. Other than that, walang lalabas dyan. Kasi hindi siya searchable. So, the only time a company would be able to know your information is if and when you give your exact resume link to that company. So, ikaw may control. Ayos? So, tuloy natin. Okay, tuloy natin. So, if you're going to search for companies, what do? Just go to the website of jobson80.com, search for companies. Kung may lumabas, edi meron. Pag walang lumabas, edi wala. Diba? Ganun lang yan. Huwag at ipilitin magkaroon ng something kung wala talaga. Diba? Okay, so ano gagawin? Tingnan mo yung mga companies. Kung meron kang type, edi gawin nyo, check nyo yung opportunities. After that, you now submit your information to that company. Okay, and when you submit your information to the company, it will ask for your resume link and password. So ikaw lang bibigay ng consent dun sa company. Okay? Now another option is for you to send resumes via email. Now there's nothing wrong in sending resumes through email. Ang tanong dito is how are you sending your resumes through email? Do you do it like this? Do you say, dear HR manager, I'd like to apply for the following position. This is my resume. Tapos mag-a-attach ka ng Word file, PDF file, or whatever file you have. If you're doing those attachments pa, ang tawag dyan, traditional, pampabagal, makaluma. Hindi ko sinabing mali. Ang sabi ko lang, traditional, pampabagal, makaluma. Bakit? Hindi mo kailangan mag-attach anything anymore. If you're going to write an email and send your resume, just simply type your resume link there. Dear HR manager, I would like to apply for the following position. This is my resume. In this example, Antonio Juan de la Cruz, jobson80.com, send. Tapos na. Ganun lang kabilis. Diba? Whatever changes you need to do, you put it inside your resume link. You don't have to keep on sending another attachment. Eh, paano kung imagine mo na lang, nag-attach ka ng Word file, diba? Ng PDF file. E tapos nagpalit ka ng address, nagpalit ka ng phone number, ano gagawin mo? Email mo na may HR. Dear HR manager, I'm sending you my updated resume. Ganun ba? E paano kung 2 months later na lumipat ka ng bahay, iba na address mo, send ka ulit ng bagong resume? Dear HR manager, I'm sending you my updated, most recent resume. I don't think you'll do that. Kasi kung ganun ang ginagawa mo, sayang sa oras siya, nakapagod sa part mo, lalong-lalo naman sa part ng HR, mas nakapagod to keep track kung saan dyan yung pinaka-updated na attachment or pinaka-updated na resume ng aplikante. And this time around, if you have your resume link, all you need to do is just update your resume link at lahat na may alam ng resume link mo, makikita nila yung pinaka-real-time update ng profile or information. Ayos ba? Ayos ba? Oh, sige, another one. For those who wanted to use a hard copy, gusto mo talaga may hard copy ka when you apply to those companies, you want to give something, then this is also possible. What do you do? You go to your dashboard inside your job seeker account, then you can print your resume link. Mamili ka lang, one column or two column version. Either way, the system will try to compress everything into one page. O diba? Maginhawa sa buhay. So kung gusto mo talaga mag-apply sa mga kumpanya, hindi mo na kailangan mag-prepare ng maraming mga pages. Minsan, diba, yung mga aplikante, mga 2-3 pages ang isang set ng resume. Palibasa, yung font size, size 45. Kaya umaabot ng 2-3 pages. O diba? Pero this time, the system will try to compress everything na into one page. Just in case you really want to have a hard copy. O diba? Tipid. Tipid. Okay? Another thing pa for me to encourage you to do is you use resume link cards. Resume link cards. Ano itong resume link card? Kung sa mga nagtatrabaho na, tawag namin business card. Sa mga nag-a-apply, tawag dyan resume link card. So in one piece of paper, whether short bond or long bond paper, you can now design it your own way. You can design it depende kung ano ang gusto mo, pagiging creativity mo. Ikaw bahala. You can make 10, 20 sets of cards. Depende sa laki o liit. Diba? Kasi laki na index card or kasi liit lang naman normal business cards natin. Diba? So, depende. So, maybe in one long bond paper, you can make 10, 20 sets of cards na. And so, after you have it printed out, pwede ka na ngayon maggupit-gupit. Gupit-gupit na lang. Diba? 10 or 20, bawat kumpanya, you can now start to give that as a hard copy. Hard copy pa rin naman yan eh. But this time, why am I encouraging you to use resume link cards instead of the traditional long bond or short bond paper? Bakit? Una-una, tipid. Diba? Because of course, right now, eto, tipid. Kasi if you're going to apply to 20 companies, you don't need to print 20 sets of long bond papers. You just need to print one long bond paper and cut 20 small pieces of resume link cards. O, diba? That's for the cost side. Tipid na. Pangalawa, at mas importante, security of information. Diba? You want to have peace of mind. Paano ko nasabi yan? Kapag ikaw yung nagbigay sa isang kumpanya ng long bond paper or short bond paper, example lang, no? It's a traditional resume. And for some reason, nilipad ng hangin. Okay? Nilipad ng hangin. Hindi mo kasalanan. Kasalanan ng hangin eh. Diba? May nakapulot na stranger. May nakapulot na stranger. All your information, alam na nung stranger. Tama? And you cannot deny it because you know what I'm saying is true. Diba? Hindi mo kilala pero alam niya yung details mo. Now, using your resume link card, same scenario. Nagbigay ka ng resume link card sa company, nilipad ng hangin ngayon. May na stranger na nakapulot, okay lang. Bakit? Kampante ka. Kasi yung resume link, ikaw may control ng privacy settings mo. That's why, in your resume link card, what I recommend, you just simply put your name and your resume link. Dalawa lang. That's it. If you want to put your mobile number, it's okay. It's up to you. You can put it there. Diba? Pero ang point ko is, resume link, pwede na siya makita ng mga HR or mga companies na bibigyan mo. Diba? So you have peace of mind now. Okay? So there's a lot of advantages using resume links. In fact, doon pa lang sa privacy portion, panalong-panalo ka na. Ikaw ang may control ng privacy settings mo real time. Pagdating sa speed of hire, it becomes faster and more efficient because whatever you want to show the HR, you just attach it there. Whatever the HR needs from you, they just ask from you. Diba? You take a picture, you scan them, upload it there, and later on, pag okay na, you now turn off yung privacy settings mo. Diba? Or you can remove them in the attachments. Diba? Cost efficient, definitely wala tong gastos, tipid. Diba? If you're thinking, ay sir, paano po yung internet? Kailangan ko ng pang-load. Pwede ka maging resourceful. Connect lang tayo sa mga libreng Wi-Fi. O, diba? And then, pagdating sa flexibility, if you really want to have it printed out, yung inyong resume, you also have the option to print it out. That's like how I showed it to you, one column or two column version. Either way, it's really up to you. Pero ang point ko is, resume link na lahat yan. Okay? And you can use this to any platform, whatever platform you want to share it to. You want to share it sa mga messenger nyo, you want to share it sa email, sa Viber, sa text, di ba? Gusto mo, kaya ko bahala. Di ba? Gusto mo, sulat mo sa papel, tapos gawa ka ng airplane, palipad mo, di ba? May nakakuha, alam na yung resume link mo. Ikaw bahala. Okay, ikaw may control kung sino ang gusto mo bigyan. Okay? You don't have to use your USBs anymore. You don't have to save it hard drive. Baka mawala pa yung USB nyo. Delikado. Diba? Wag na. Baka kung ano pa makita ng mga nakakapulot ng mga USB na yan. Okay? So you don't need to worry about compatibility as well because this is compatible to any platform. If you're using Android, you're using Safari, kung ano magamit mo, pwede yan sa kahit anong version. Okay? And so, just to promote lang, if you want to be part of our team, we're also hiring. Mismo sa jobs180.com, we're hiring for several opportunities, several vacancies yan. Check out na lang yung aming jobson80.com/jobson80 na page. Okay? And by the grace of God, shout out lang ako, right now we have more than 400 plus colleges and university partners nationwide from north all the way to the south of the Philippines. Thank you, Lord. O, diba? Ang kinalat namin, hindi lang virus. Biro lang. Kinalat namin, resume link. Yan ang kinalat natin. So, a lot of schools now, including your alma mater, are now using the resume link. So, I hope it doesn't stop here. No? You become a blessing to others as well. If you have friends, you have yung mga relatives mo, nasa tingin mo, kailangan itong tool na ito, you can share it to them. Wala namang bayad eh. Libre naman yan. Okay? And so, as we close this portion, I'd like to discuss some of the frequently asked questions. Baka ito yung mga agam nyo or ito yung mga questions na gusto nyo tanungin. Sagutin ko na muna. Okay? Unang tanong, can I give my resume links to companies who do not know about jobs180.com? The answer is absolutely yes. Basta alam nila eksaktong link mo at ikaw may control, sino bibigyan mo nun? Ikaw lang ang magbibigay, diba? So ikaw lang may alam sino binigyan mo. Okay? Now, second question, is it the same as other job platform, kagaya ng JobStreet, LinkedIn, or any other job site? The answer is no. May dalawang pagkakaiba. And let me use an example here. Let me do a shout out to JobStreet, no? Because I think you guys know what JobStreet is. So shout out lang to them, sa mga nasa JobStreet. If you're using JobStreet na resume, you can only apply to companies who are using JobStreet. If you're applying to a company who is not using JobStreet, you cannot use your JobStreet resume anymore. Pero pag gamit mo yung resume link mo, pwede mo yung gamitin kahit na saan, kahit na kanino, kahit na anong platform. Diba? Basta alam ng HR yung eksaktong link mo at ikaw magbibigay nun. That's the first difference. Second difference, if you have already submitted your JobStreet resume to an HR, you cannot change anything anymore. Well, you can on your end, but it will not be reflected on the HR. Hindi siya magiging real-time update. Comparing it to resume link ni Jobs180, you can update it real-time. 2 days later, 5 minutes later, 6 weeks later, ikaw bahala, anytime nag-update ka ng information, lahat na in-update mo, dagdag bawas, will be reflected real-time across all na may alam ng resume link mo. Okay? So those are your two major differences. Now, pagdating sa pangatlong question, yan ang pinakasimpleng tanong. Can I keep my information secured? I hope by this time, na-convince ko na kayo na ito na ang pinaka-secured na job application platform. Okay? So, use your resume link. Number four question, I think, is the most important question. How often should you update your resume link? The answer is every time. Every time na meron kang babaguhin. Okay? Every time na meron kang babaguhin. Lalong-lalo na yung contact details mo. Kasi imagine, binago mo lahat. Binago mo yung work experience mo, nagkaroon ng awards, nagkaroon ng achievement, hindi ka naman makontakt ng HR. Wala rin, di ba? Sayang din. That's why you have to update yung contact details niyo. Okay? And the last question is just a trivia. Trivia lang. Palaisipan. Why is this called jobs180.com? This is called jobs180.com because we want to turn your life around 180 degrees. And in case you're wondering, no, you wanted to raise a concern, bakit hindi po 360? Kasi pag 360 degrees, you only go back to where you started. Ikot ka lang na ikot, ikot ka lang na ikot, wala kang pupuntahan. Diba, bumabalik ka lang kung saan ka galing. Oh, ha? O, diba? Char-char lang yan. Okay, so anyways, again, kung meron pa kayo ibang questions, just in case you have questions, okay, you may send those questions here through our website, www.jobson80.com. You can also email us or email me here sa info@jobson80.com. You can like us on Facebook, also on Twitter, Instagram, pati na rin sa TikTok. Okay, so check us out on all our social media platform. Okay, again, my name is Kim Chu. Wa, don't forget the wa. Okay, isang magandang araw po sa inyo lahat. Thank you.
All right, so thank you so much, Sir Kim. So students, we are now opening the floor for questions. So if you have any questions, you can type them in the comment section. So hi, Sir Kim. Good morning.
Hi, good morning. Morning.
Hi po. So sir, since nagpo-formulate pa po yung mga students ng question po, tanong ko lang po sir if audible po ako or hindi po ano yung connection.
I can hear you. I can hear you well.
Ay, okay. Yung video mo lang pala yung ano, yung naglalag. Okay lang po yung audio niya po. Okay, sige po. So I have a few questions myself po sir, if that's okay.
Yeah, go lang. Ah, okay. Ask the questions.
Sir. So first sir, maganda naman na product yung yung resume link ng jobson80.com. But yung tanong ko po is bakit siya free?
It is free because job seekers can use this tool. They don't need to be charged. Eh. Sa totoo lang, kaya ka nga naghahanap ng trabaho kasi syempre gusto mo rin naman makatulong, 'di ba? Hindi dagdag pabigat pa, gagawa ka na lang ng information, mag-a-apply ka. Babayad ka pa, papahirapan mo pa sarili mo or dagdag pa sa gastos. So the reason why this tool was created is also to help the job seekers make their process more efficient and more importantly, is to keep their information secured. So if you have a tool that can help them to do that, tapos wala pang bayad, then all the more that I think there's reason to use for itong platform na ito. Yun po. So walang bayad, di ba?
Okay, so maganda talaga siyang help sir, no? Other than convenient siya, wala din siyang bayad. Okay, so sa next ko na question po sir is, mostly kasi ngayon sa mga students or sa mga job seekers, may iba't ibang platform na ginagamit and isa dun sa pinakasikat is yung Canva. So ano po yung pinagkaiba ng Canva resume format ng sa resume link?
There's a very big difference. Kasi narinig ko rin yan, marami sa mga job seekers right now, they're using Canva as a way to design their resume. Maybe it's also easy, no, to use. However, these are the things that you have to consider. Una sa lahat, if you're using a Canva file, yung link mo, gibberish. When you save your Canva link, di ba, yung Canva mo na file, gibberish yan eh. Yung madami-daming alphanumeric, whatever code. So I don't think you'll give that to the company. So ano gagawin mo? Kailangan pa siya i-convert into a shorter form. Maybe you have to shorten into a bit.ly na link. Yung iba naman, i-convert siya to a QR code. Diba? So depende. Now, those links have limited duration lang. May limited duration yung mga bit.ly eh, sa pagkaalala ko. Ah. So after a while, let's say a month or 2 months later, I'm not really sure about the duration. Pero I'm sure may expiry yan. So pag gano'n na nangyari, ano gagawin mo? Gagawa ka na ng panibagong bit.ly, mamimigay ka na naman sa mga kumpanya. Di ba? So masyadong matrabaho, mahassle yan. Now, another thing I want to emphasize is yung security feature nga eh. Which is, pagdating po sa Canva, paano mo i-hide yung mga information ayaw mo ipakita sa companies? So you have to save another file. Maybe may Canva file 1, wala kang address, wala kang birthday, wala kang references. Tapos may Canva file number 2 ka na naka-open yung ibang information, di ba? So, masyadong ano siya mahassle on the part of the HR. Now, I don't have anything with Canva. It's okay, no? Canva is there to help us design mas mabilis, no? Yung drag, di ba? Click and drag. Mabilis yan eh. Pero pagdating sa pag-apply, I think it's still best that you use resume link because of the convenience and the security aspects of it. Di ba? Yun. So, dito mabilis lang, turn on, turn off ka lang ng button eh. Diba? Ayaw mo pakita birthday mo, turn off. Ayaw mo pakita address mo, turn off. Diba? Tapos pag gusto mo ipakita na or i-share, turn on. O diba? Tapos save ka lang. So mas mabilis. Yun po. So those are the big difference the way I see it. Because Canva is just another parang drawing pad. Parang ganun. Yan yung nakita ko. It's just another Word file, basically.
Tapos hindi na kailangan i-layout, sir, sa resume.
Oo, wala kang layout. O, ganun lang siya. Para lang siyang Word file na hindi mo kailangan i-layout. O, tama. Ganun po. Diba? So, yun lang.
Okay. So, nice naman talaga yung resume link, sir, no? So, sir, we have a question from one of the students po.
Okay.
So, from Ayo Plaridel. So, if you are a fresh graduate that has no work experience, what do you think is the next best thing to include in the resume?
So, the next best thing for you to do, Ma'am Karina, is that yung mga relevant experiences mo, kahit na walang connect dun sa course mo, ilagay mo dyan. Okay, your skills, lagay mo dyan. Remember, companies hire you not because of your course, they hire you because of your skills. So kung meron kang mga skills, example, may mga school activities kayo, meron kang mga organization na sinalihan, meron kang mga exposure, no, sa internship nyo, or maybe in and kahit mga sideline or mga racket-racket, basta itong mga bagay na to are actual experiences. I think these are the things that you have to highlight, no, in your information sa resume link mo. Yon. So don't worry. Lahat naman na nag-a-apply na wala pang work experience, eh, it doesn't mean naman na it is a disadvantage on your part, di ba? Hindi naman eh. It doesn't mean that it is a disadvantage. You just have to reposition lang. Ilagay mo lang dyan. And be truthful about your data. Huwag ka magpa-fabricate ng information just so you want to, parang gusto mo, syempre, best foot forward, di ba? Papasikat ka. Huwag mo lalagay dyan yung mga info na false ang mga details. Kasi lalo ka lang malalagot. Diba? Sabi mo yung totoo, diba? Mabuti pa yun. Ayun lang. I hope na-answer ko yung tanong, Ma'am Yumi.
Alright. So, thank you so much, Sir Kim. So, Sir, I have one last question po before okay. I mag-end sa portion ng question and answer portion natin. So, Sir, yung question ko is, how can we educate users about best practices for maintaining their security and privacy while using the platform for job applications?
Ah, okay. Ang best practices that we're doing right now is we're educating more and more users or job seekers about this platform, especially itong resume link. The good thing here is that when we do webinars or when we do actual face-to-face na seminars, we're teaching them how to set their privacy setting. Kasi yan yung advantage ng resume link. Eh. May control ka 100% as a job seeker, as a user, no, as account owner ng resume link nyo, ikaw may full control 100% anong information gusto mo ipakita or itago sa public. Kaya, the things that we're doing right now is we're reaching out to more and more people about this platform. We're not saying that you do not use yung mga ibang traditional platform. We're just saying lang that this gives you a lot of advantages, especially in terms of flexibility, in terms of your security, in terms of your job hunting process. Diba? Yan naman yung focus nito. Kaya siya binansagan na the most secured tool for your job application. Ayun. So I hope I'm able to answer the question. Yun po.
Apo, yes naman, Sir Kim. So, Sir Kim, so thank you so much, sir, sa pagsagot sa mga tanong ko and sa mga sa tanong ng mga students. And, ano ba to? So, thank you so much din, sir, for introducing to us the resume link of jobson80.com. So
thank you rin.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir. And tingin ko po, sir, nasa biyahe ka po. So.
Oo nga, tumabi lang ako, syempre, para makafocus tayo sa Q&A. I also want to remind them to check out the link, the one that you're seeing there. Nagsuscroll sa link right
yes
now.
Po.
Check out nyo po yung link na yan. You will see a lot of companies there. You can explore. Marami sa mga companies nandyan are partner ng school ninyo, ng Arellano University. Kung meron naman po nakikinig dito na hindi taga Arellano University, it's also okay for you to check out those companies on that link as well as jobs180.com, www.jobs180.com. Yun lang po. So good luck sa job hunting ninyo.
Okay, so thank you so much, Sir Kim, and take care po sa biyahe niyo, sir. Bye, sir.
Okay, bye-bye.
Okay, sir. All right. So if you have any additional questions for Sir Kim or if you would like to know more about Resume Link, you can email him at info@jobson80.com or you may visit facebook.com/jobson80. So don't forget to visit your career portal, guys. It's school.jobson80.com/au. All right, so we surely know how to apply for jobs using the resume link, which is also very convenient and cost efficient for us students. All right, so nakiki-students ako, di ba? So as we become job seekers, we surely need to know how to create our resume. So Resume Link is a powerful tool and a secure tool for our job application processes. So before we proceed to our next speaker, so we'll have a little bit of an icebreaker. So dahil hindi tayo naka-premium sa live, ang tawag ng game na ito ay Don't Skip Ads. So where we guess the TV commercial. All right. So don't skip ads. So guess the TV commercial. Ito po yung mga mechanics niya. So first, we will show series of TV commercial clips. Next, players need to guess the TV commercial. So you players is kayo. So you are given 10 seconds to type in your answers in the comment section. But you may only start typing after your answer after the go signal, which is alam mo yard. So makikita niyo sa screen yung go signal. And 5 winners So there are 5 winners. So each winner will receive a GCash loan. So all right. So I hope everyone is ready na. So to know na ready na kayo guys, we will have a trial run. All right. So here po.
Merong leak? Merong stain?
Merong duda sa long pad mo? Palitan mo.
I am your mother. You listen to me. Stop all the mansplaining. No one's listening. Tell me who gave you the permission to speak. I am your mother. You listen to me. You just.
All right, so time's up. So I can see in the comment section.
I am your mother. I am your mother.
You the next. What is Simis? Simis Calves. If I am correct. So ganyan yun.
Meron duda sa long pad mo? Palitan mo yan.
Switch to Madas Long. The fastest absorbing pad. No longer.
Ibang ka ba? Walang duda.
Switch to Madas Long.
Alright. So, I hope everyone is ready for round one. Alright, so I will be okay. Ayan yung first round one commercial natin. So sipa, dalawang sarap na sama, sosikali ng ulam, dalawang sarap sa isang bangay, deeper sticky ng ulam. Sosikali ng ulam.
Pag dalawang bigatin nagsama, ito.
Okay, guys. Reminder that you may you may type in your answers after this.
I am your mother. You listen to me. Stop all the mansplaining. No one's listening. Tell me who gave you the permission to speak. I am your mother. You listen to me. You just a bum 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 bum. You just
so it is actually. All right, so you are correct, Jollibee. But guys, all the answers before not valid. We may type in our answers before. I hope everyone got it. All right, so thank you so much for our second round. Again, let's go to our second round.
Pag dalawang bigatin nagsama,
ito. Okay. So Jollibee B daw ang saya. O may nag-answer ng McDo. Okay, so for our round 2, are you ready? Ito na yung commercial.
Babangon tayo, susulong tayo, babangon tayo, susulong tayo.
Magpapanat ng buto, matutodong pagkakayon, dahil pag may tinanil, tsak na may aanilin. Tanim na kape ay bibig, sa tulong nyo di susuko. At ang pagbangon natin, ang higitin sa mundo. Oh, oh, babangon tayo, susulong tayo. Dahil ang pagbangon natin ito, ang higitin sa pangarap.
I am your mother. You listen to me. Stop all the mansplaining. No one's listening. Tell me who gave you the permission to speak. I am your mother.
Right, so what is the answer? So I'm answering by Coffee Club Blanca. So your answer is Nesco. So para kanino ka bumabangon?
pagpapanat ng buto. Todo-todong pagkakayod dahil pag may tinanim,
tsak na may aanihin.
Tanim na kape ay Yñigo, at tulong nyo di susuko.
At ang pagbangon natin
ang gigising sa mundo. Dagamon tayo, susulong tayo
dahil ang pagbangon.
Alright, so for our round 3, are you all ready? So reminder ha, your answers, type them in after the go signal.
Yeah, inis ka na ba sa lakit? Sa lakit ng iyong damit, sobrang pawis na ninikit.
Di na ba matikis ang lakit?
I am your mother. You listen to me. Stop all the mansplaining. No one's listening. Tell me who gave you the permission to speak. I am your mother. You listen to me. You just a bum bum bum.
Thumbs up, Sony. All right, so it is actually Downy. Sorry guys, medyo nawala yung ano, yung device. Alright, I hope I am audible. Okay. So for our next round, alright, so I hope everyone got the correct answer. So my hatid pawis, Downy. Sige. Alright, so for rounds 1, 2, 3, we have our winners here. San ba yan? Okay, for our round 1, it's Miss Trisha Ann Dasig. Round 2, Renel Resentes. And for our round 3, wait lang kasi medyo nawala ako kanina. Okay, for our round 3, it's... Counted ba tong Downy Antibac? Ah, okay, si Renel yung sa round 3 pala. Okay, so si Renel yung sa round 3. Then, alright, so si Cyrus ba sa round Downy. Okay, sige. So for our round 4,
yes. Nice, ganda. Ang dami niya na.
Perfect time for the madlang people.
Even better para sa mga dapper ka. Let's eat. It's showtime.
So much to love with the new and better chicken McDo. Much malaki. Much juicier. Much crispier.
Pasosyal pa natin.
Paano?
Chibugs. Chibugs.
Much masarap when shared this Christmas.
O ano, lunch naman sunod? Busy tayo pag-lunch. Ayun nga pala. And yung Mac delivery. You just pindot-pindot the app and they will add it, to you, the McDo.
I am your mother. You listen to me. Stop all the mansplaining. No one's listening. Tell me who gave you the permission to speak.
Alright, so what is the answer? So the answer is actually
nice! Good luck! Ang dami niya na.
All these commercials about food, no, nakakagutom. So for our round 5, our last round, guys, so be quick.
Hi, Betty! I'm live from campus, and I'm putting...
I am your mother. You listen to me. Stop all the mansplaining. No one's listening. Shh. Tell me who gave you the permission to speak. I am your mother. You listen to me. You just a bum bum bum. Bum bum bum.
Okay, so the answer for that commercial is actually
Hi, 4-in-1.
Right, okay. So guys, you are the list of winners. So I hope na take note na mga winners ito. So the winners are Trisha Ann Dasig, Renels Resentes, Cyrus Tagalog, and Melissa Canada for round 4 and 5. Right? Again, yung mga winners for round 1 is Trisha Ann Dasig, round 2, Renel Resentes, round 3, Cyrus Tagalog, round 4, Judisa Canada, and round 5 is Judisa Canada. Sorry, it's Canada pala. Alright, so for those winners, how to claim your prize, guys? You just have to message your complete name, year on end course, and your valid GCash number and send it to the email karina.aquino@arellano.edu.ph. So reminders lang na it is valid until 3 p.m. today. Okay, so again, ito po yung how to claim your prize para sa game. Alright, so I hope na nabuhayan lahat. Or I hope nagising lahat ng diwa na mga nanonood. So that is for our little icebreaker. Thank you so much for participating, guys. Alright. So I hope that everyone is as energetic as I am today, no, after ng icebreaker natin. So we will be, I will be presenting to you our second speaker, which will be introducing us the after graduation checklist. So she is a senior human resource in Kooapps. So it is a game development studio in the Philippines for 10 years. And she is a graduate of AB Development Communication. So let us all welcome Ms. Vera Tabuzo, the senior HR of Kooapps. So hi, Ms. Vera. Good morning, po.
Hi, good morning. Can you hear me?
All right. Yes, yes, ma'am. But your audio is quite mahina.
Hello?
Oh, yan. Yan po, ma'am.
Alright. Okay, thank you. Alright, yes, so ma'am. Yumi, thank you for introducing me and good morning to all the Arellano students present here today in our talk. Okay, so let me present our topic for today, after graduation checklist. Okay, so let me just introduce myself a bit. So since it's also graduation season, of course, I have to put my graduation photo. So at least I can relate with you guys. So anyways, a bit of my background. Currently, I'm working as the senior HR in Kooapps Philippines Corporation. So it's a mobile game development studio based in Makati. So I joined here May 2013 and still here, still working with the company. So when I joined the company, we were just 20 employees back then, and I helped company grow to now almost 150 employees. But before I was able to do that, I was just like you guys 11 years ago. So fresh out of college and was the first in our clan to finish college. So I didn't know where to start or what to prepare for this adulting. So you guys are lucky that Jobs 180 prepared this talk or presentation to you guys, so you are better prepared on the next step that you're going to take. So what really actually lies ahead? So what lies ahead after getting out of the four corners of your classroom? Sometimes it gets scary navigating the world unknown, isn't that right? So there's actually a lot of options that you may take. So first, you can enjoy this transition period to get a vacation. So spend more time with family or your friends before your schedule actually gets too fully booked. Sometimes in 1 month, it might not be able to meet with your friends because they might be, they might have different schedule than you, and etc. And during this time as well, you can reflect and check the requirements if you're pursuing postgraduate studies such as getting master's degree. Another option that you can take would be upskilling. So you can attend bootcamp, training, or workshop to further improve your skills and better land your dream job. And last year is the job searching. So I think most of you guys will be looking for a job soon. So we'll focus on this more. Okay. So first thing that you need to have after, or one of the checklists for your post-graduation materials would be the resume. So resume means it's a formal document highlighting your skills, qualifications, and education. So if as much as possible, keep hard copy and soft copy. But if you're often editing your requirements, it's better that you have your resume link printed on a card or like your business card, and then you can just update or change the content according to the position that you're applying for, but the resume link will still stay the same. So just a tip for you guys, make sure that you tailor fit your resume based on the job that you're applying to. So example, you're applying as mobile game programmer in our company. So you read in the job description that we need someone with programming background. So you need to put the programming languages that you know of. And make sure not to lie in your application. So we will find that out during the interview. So only know, only put the things that you know. So be factual for the things that you put on your resume. And example also, if you're applying for the artist position, you need to put the link of your online portfolio, which I'll be discussing also in the next slide. Okay, so here are the do and don'ts of putting or what to put in your resume or how to prepare your resume. So first, do keep it short, clean, and simple. So usually for recruiters, we don't have much time to scan or to read all the applications in just one sitting. So it's important that your resume would just be around 1 to 2 pages only. Okay, so at least we covered everything and we can already assess whether we will be inviting you for the next step or the interview already. Okay, so next one is please do highlight your skills and qualifications. Do not put them in the bottom because we want to know if you're fit for the role right away. So we don't want to be like reading all through the sections and then only find out later that you're not qualified or you don't have the skills or qualifications for the job that you're applying for. Okay, so as much as possible, highlight it. If you can put it on the top, that would be better. Or if you can put formatting that can highlight your skills and qualifications, that would be better. So next one here, also add relevant experiences. So it can be your internship, it can be the volunteer experiences that you have inside school or even outside school. And next one is put updated contact details. So as what Sir Kim mentioned earlier, that you're qualified for the job but we cannot contact you, so you just miss your opportunity there. Okay, so always make sure that you put your updated contact number. If you're using two numbers, please just indicate the one that you're always using. Okay, so at least we don't miss the other number also. And for the email, keep it formal as much as possible, like your first name and then your last name, or it could be like a variation of your name and then your last name. Do not add unnecessary numbers or letters in there or special characters, because it would be hard also once you give out your contact information. So when you give it verbally, right? So please make it formal. If you haven't created your own email yet for like job application, so you can start making it now. So all your emails are just for job applications. Okay. And next one here, our last tip would be, please do double check for typo. And if ever we notice like your resume is missing something, or most of the time it has wrong spelling, it gives you the vibe that you are not prepared enough for the application, or you are not careful enough with the details. So please make sure to double check your resume for any typos. And on the other hand, we have the things that you should not do. Okay, so please do not cram all information or overshare. So give some information for you to share it during your interview. Okay. And next one, do not put personal information such as mother's maiden name. Most of the time it's being used for security in the bank accounts. Okay. Or other private information. Okay. So do not put your height, weight, because most of the time it's not being used in the job you're applying for. Okay, unless I think you're applying for like flight attendant, you might need to have your height there, but most of the time it's not needed. Okay, do not use also flowery word and jargons. So if ever there are technical stuff that you learn from college or from your course, it's better that you save it during your interview. So like for the recruiters, some of us might not be able to relate to that, so it's better that you use that during the interview already. And next one here, do not choose distracting graphic or template, because most of the time it would be hard to read. So we will just spend time trying to figure out what actually you put in here or whatsoever. So as much as possible, keep it simple as what I've mentioned earlier. And please do not copy job descriptions word for word. Okay, so in here, if ever you read in the job description that it's actually that we need something like this and like that, and then you copied it in your resume, we will be able to find out once you submitted your resume to us. And some of it might not be applicable to you, so avoid copy pasting it. Okay, So that's for the do's and don'ts of resume writing or resume creating resume. Next one here, as what I also mentioned earlier for the portfolio. So portfolio is a compilation of your best output or artwork over a period of time used for assessing your performance or progress. So this is where you put all the works that you have done, like from first year, could be like from first year until your last year in your college. So you can actually check how much have you developed already. So if ever you started from one art style and then after progressing, then you can already do other art styles. So portfolio will be the best one to showcase your progression. So this is actually required for the artist or for those applying for the art position. Okay, so as what Sir Kim also mentioned earlier during his talk, that you don't need to wait for the recruiters to contact you and ask for your resume. Immediately, you can already put it in your resume. Okay, so for the portfolio, this will also give the employer a better perspective of your skills and capabilities. So this is like a secondary to the resume. If you said that you can do sculpture, and then in your portfolio, you also put some sculpture pieces there or some sculpture photos. Make sure that it's also it also belongs to you guys. Do not steal any artwork from other person. Okay, so if you don't know where to store it first, or if you don't know where to start, you can use Google Drive first, or you can also upload your portfolio or your sample work in Jobs 180 resume link. So they also give you an option to upload your portfolio there. So at least once you apply, everything is already there. We don't need to look for other places. Okay. So how to start? So first is you choose the best output to represent you, and as much as possible, add watermark so that other people, when they see or if ever you posted it publicly, it prevents other people from copying or stealing, prevents other people from stealing your work. So next one, adjust the content based on the purpose. So if you're applying for illustrator position, we better find illustrations also in your portfolio, not just like photography, not just like video samples. So it's best that you tailor fit it also based on the position that you're applying for. So for us, for multimedia artist position, what we're looking for are video editors, also motion graphics. So it's best that you put those videos related to multimedia. Okay. Next one here is you have to explore which site you want to host it. So Google Drive, you can also do the resume link. You can also do DeviantArt, Behance, or your own website. But usually for own website, it has payment. Or usually it costs you, it costs you around, I'm not sure right now, but it costs you for like subscription and other things. Okay. And next one is organize your work and make it more interactive. So if you have, maybe you need to group your portfolio. So like first section would be more on the illustration. Second one is for the video. Next section is for 3D. Do not scatter them, okay? Because it will be hard to judge whether whether you're really applying for illustration job or for a 3D artist job. Okay. And next one, so if you decide to create a portfolio, okay, so if you want to host it outside or in your own website, please make sure to include a bit of your description and how to contact you, because usually we will be going out of your resume. So if ever you pass the portfolio screening, we don't know how to contact you, and you might, we might have a hard time finding you in the pile of the resume we just read. Okay. All right. So next one here is the PERT certificate. So all right, sorry. Sorry for the pause. All right, so birth certificate, this is the vital document that shows your birth record and other important information related to your identity. So for the birth certificate, you can actually request it through the PSA offices and it can be released within the day. Sometimes the hassle is just comes from lining up in the office. So if you arrive in the PSA office around 11 or lunch, sometimes the line is already very long. So that's the only downside of acquiring or getting your birth certificate through PSA offices. Next one is online. So online is convenient, so you can just order it through just few clicks. You can order it also just through your phone or when you're in front of your computer. The only downside is it's more expensive and it takes longer than getting it from PSA office. So usually delivery takes 2 to 3 days to arrive. So usually for birth certificate also, you would need to use that when opening SSS accounts or when you're getting your valid IDs, which we will be discussing in the next slide. So valid ID. So this is a highly reliable government issued document certifying your identity. So just like in school, no ID, no entry. In adulting version, most of the transactions you will have will involve ID. So if you're going for an interview in another building or in another office, before you can even get to the office that you for interview, you will be asked to present an ID. Okay, so it's best that you prepare it already and you have it with you once you go to different job interviews, or if you're already hired, then opening ATM accounts would be easy or swift. Okay, so there's just like clarification. So there's difference between primary ID versus secondary ID. So primary ID, it's universally accepted across different institutions, so it contains your name, picture, birth date, and signature. So example of this are passport, driver's license, SSS, UMID, and PRC ID. So for primary ID, they're also harder to be manipulated or edited. Okay, so that's what you need to remember. And my tip here is you need to get the postal ID first because this is the easiest ID and the fastest ID that can be released. Other IDs will also require other valid IDs. So this is the meme, this is the saying or the running joke comes from, I'm already getting an ID or I'm applying for an ID because I don't have one. Why do you need to ask for another ID? All right, so I hope you don't encounter that. Please get your postal ID first. So other ID will take more time to be processed or to be released. So postal ID is actually faster than getting the national ID. And right now, the national ID that they're releasing is still on cardboard or paper, as far as I know. So on the other hand, we have the secondary ID. Mostly it's paper or cardboard material. And you also have to provide your own photo and sign on your own time and then have it laminated. Okay, so example of this would be company ID, PhilHealthTeen, and cedula. So for the secondary ID, if you present one, you need to present another ID with it. Okay. So next one here is the TOR. So TOR is transcript of record. It's an official document that gives proof of one's educational qualification. So it also lists down the school, the scores, units taken, grades, and credits gained throughout your entire academics or school year. Okay, so some of the companies actually requires TOR as part of the pre-employment requirements or if you're applying for postgraduate studies. Okay, so for us, actually, we don't require TOR because we want you to actually show us what are the things that you have learned from your school and not just like TOR speak for yourself. Okay. So basically, that's the end of the checklist that I have here for you guys. So more of this, you can actually explore also later on, or you can connect with us later to check or to ask for more details. But I would like to give you some quotes here. So the difference between school and life. In school, you're taught a lesson and then given a test. In life, you're given a test that teaches you a lesson. So this quote is from Tom Baudet. Welcome to adulting, guys. And congratulations as well, dear graduates. We look forward to see you as our next programmer, QA tester, PM, artist, marketing, or HR. So if you are going to apply for our company, please go to jobs180.com/QAppsPH. I also included here the landing website or our company site in Jobs 180, so you don't get confused if ever you see some copycats. Okay, so thank you for you guys. Thank you for attending this talk and connect with us. You can reach through us through our email jobs@kooappsinc.com, and can call us through this landline. Go to our website also, kooapps.com. Our Facebook page is Kooapps Philippines. Instagram is Kooapps Games, and LinkedIn is Kooapps. So that's it for my talk. Thank you.
All right. So thank you so much, Miss Vera. So we are now opening the floor for questions. So students, if you have any questions, you can type them in the comment section. So thank you so much, Miss Vera. No. So as the students are formulating their questions, I have one question myself po.
Sure po.
All right. With the checklist po na binigay niyo sa in your experience po, nung ikaw yung first time na job seeker, ano po yung mga challenges na encounter niyo po as you are doing that checklist po habang nag-apply pa din ng jobs, ganun?
Okay, the number one headache that I have encountered is actually processing documents with government agencies. Back then, our RDO, like the BIR staff, was actually not that helpful. that's the first time that I got scolded for not knowing things. So yeah, I think that's terrifying for like a fresh graduate trying to accomplish the checklist that we have. But for us, since I've already went through that stage, when we hire new employees, we actually help them as much as possible. So we don't want them to encounter people like that. So right now also there are some changes already from the way they process things. So right now when you are actually applying for like example for a teen, it's actually applied through the company. So there's online system that the BIR use. So you cannot go directly to them and ask for just for team, for your own team. Yeah. I think for the NBI, because sometimes NBI slots get full right away, so you might get like 1 month later schedule, etc.
Okay, so we actually have a question from these students, ma'am. So, question from AU Pasay. Ma'am, when it comes to the law, First-Time Job Seekers Assistance Act, that waives off document fees such as NBI clearance and such for fresh graduates, do you happen to know, ma'am, yung process and requirements?
To be honest, this is the first time that I also encountered this, the first time jobs seekers assistance. So I might not be able to help you or to give you more idea because, yeah, for NBI clearance, the first time, yeah, usually they already require around 150. So let me just research on that and then I can give you a better answer. So sorry, Ivan. This is the first time I also encountered this.
All right. So, actually, so nag-question po, yung maibibigay ko lang din na sagot since nag-process po ako nito, is you can go to your barangay and ask for, ano, for the process kasi sila yung mas may alam kung paano yan kukunin and paano yan maa-attain na mga documents. And also, pwede din sa balangay nyo, sa mga purok, ganyan. Magtanong kayo sa mga kagawad. Alright, so we actually have a second question, ma'am. Thank you din po, ma'am. So we actually have a second question. So, do we need to put on the job our on-the-job training experiences in our resume link or need na po since undergrad pa po kami? Or no need na po?
I actually advise that you put your on-the-job training, OJT, internship experience in your resume link. So that would give you a better point. Like if ever, like pogi points, because we know, or we can ask you also what are the things that you have learned during your internship, what are the skills that you have acquired that's related to the job. So it's better that you put your on-the-job training experience in your resume link.
All right. So you heard Ma'am Vera, no? So it is also important, guys. Ma'am, we actually have a few more questions in the comments. Okay. So from Judisa Cañada, what should you keep in mind po when creating your resume as well as your portfolio? So is there like a format po when creating one, or do we need to put in the even smallest detail about our experiences that is also related to the job that we are applying to?
Okay, so for format for resume, I think jobs180.com has its own format for the resume link. So you don't need to worry about what are the things that you need to put because it already has the fields that you need to input your information. But if you're going to create your own resume, most of the basic items that you need there is your, of course, your name, your contact information, your school qualifications, or your school background, educational background. But do not put anymore your primary school, okay, because that's already too long. And then you also have the skills size, soft skill, and also your hard skills. So soft skill example would be analytical skills, your detail orientedness, and technical skills are the quantifiable skills that's needed for your job. And the next one is you also have the experiences, so such as the internship, or if you have taken like part-time job, that's also okay to put it in your resume. And then other things would be like the portfolio side. So portfolio side, do we need to put, I mean, for portfolio, of course, showcasing the things that you have done already, just organize them. And smallest details, so you can just put like for experience side, you can just put the position that you have handled and also like short description of what you did in there. And you can just elaborate it further once you are in the interview already.
Okay, so thank you so much, Ms. Vera. So for the other question, we will be... My question pa po si Ma'am Karina. So what are the easiest requirements and valid ID that can be requested or obtained by recent graduates now?
Okay, easiest requirements would be the postal IDs, what I've mentioned earlier. You can also do the NBI clearance, that's also accepted as valid ID. And if there are like kiosks, or if ever there are satellite offices of the for national ID, you can also get one. For yeah, so other IDs that you can get, so far SSS also, but I think they just temporarily suspended it right now because they're also trying to migrate to different version of Umit, which also acts as your bank account.
Oh, yes daw po. Nag-create sila ng sarili nilang ID po.
Yeah, but so, for SSS, that's already part of the pre-employment requirements. Eh, so you better apply for SSS now.
Okay, so thank you so much, Miss Vera. So we are at the end of our question and answer portion po, ma'am. So thank you so much for those insightful answers. And so at, sa ating students po, thank you so much for those questions. All right.
All right,
so thank you so much, Miss Vera. And yes, ma'am, we hope to see you on our next set of webinars. And if you are interested in applying a job for Kooapps, just visit jobson80.com/Kooapps. So thank you so much, Miss Vera. Have a great day po. All right. So if you have any additional questions, or you can email us at info@jobson80.com. So for those questions na hindi namin nabasa kanina, we are going to ask them on our next speaker kasi mas applicable siya for that topic. All right. So grabe ang insightful ng talk ni Ma'am Vera. If ako yung incoming graduate pa lang, magagamit ko talaga to kasi hindi nung bago pa akong graduate, hindi ko alam po ano yung unang gagawin. May checklist pala dapat. All right. So for our last but not the least speaker, kasi for sure itong topic na ito is magagamit niyo rin when we are applying for jobs. So our third speaker will be discussing virtual interview tips. So he is an HR professional who has experience in both corporate and non-profit organizations. So he has been working in the recruiting line of human resources for 3 years with multiple fields of expertise across different industries. And he is a graduate of Bachelor of Science in Psychology from Far Eastern University. So, Far Eastern University, Cavite. So, before joining Wells Fargo, he was a senior recruiter at PSG Global Solutions, where he had the opportunity in handling healthcare-related positions and Amazon Worldwide Diversity Finance Operations. So, Mr. Claude now lends his experience in recruiting at Wells Fargo, where he handles volume hiring roles. So let us all welcome Mr. Claude Yñigo Barreras, the Recruitment Associate of Wells Fargo. Hi, sir. Good morning po.
Hi for introducing. So, hi, guys. It's nice to meet you guys here. So, again, my name is Claude, and I am a recruiting associate from Wells Fargo. So for today, we're going to be discussing just a couple of things regarding interview tips. So we know naman na interviews are some sort of care towards interview or new graduates or fresh graduates. Kasi kahit ako din, before when I started, I kind of thought that interviews were supposed to be intimidating, so on and so forth. Later on, I realized na hindi pala siya ganun. Kasi the main point of interviews is for us to know each other. So it's all about building a connection. Kumbaga, guys, it's the talking stage. You know, kumbaga.
Tama naman, sir.
So I'll be only discussing a few things lang din, so just so we can in line and you guys can have an expectation on what to do and what should you expect when it comes to interviews. So number one is that we definitely need to do prep work, and the things that we need to figure out there is number one, yung research. So let's say, for example, you are applying for Wells Fargo. So, ano ba ginagawa ni Wells Fargo? Ano ba yung mga positions na open? Magkano ba yung offers? So on and so forth. These are the things na kailangan natin gawin in order for us to have an idea. Why? Because one way or another, some of the things that will be asked to you sa interview will probably be on the job specifications as well. So, it doesn't necessarily mean naman na kailangan alam mo siya to a T, but it's also good to have an idea when you are being asked. So, for example, sa akin, when I first started working, I was a working student back then. So, luckily for me, I had the opportunity to be part of a BPO company in Cavite. And the only thing I had basically was my English communication skills. And that's about it. Like, I didn't know the process. I didn't know anything about call centers in general. Because the thing there is, nahatak lang din ako. And what I initially thought about it was, all I have to do was just talk to people, take in calls. But it's more complicated than that. And the thing that I didn't do back then was review or in research these things. So moving forward, when I went to apply to different companies and I tried to seek out multiple job applications, what I initially did was research about them. Kasi it's also one thing na alam mo kung ano yung gusto mo, but it's also one thing na naiintindihan mo kung ano yung ginagawa nila, right? So company and the role that you are applying for, those are two crucial things that you have to know. Hindi naman necessarily, like I've said before, hindi naman necessarily up to a T, but it's also good that you have an idea. Number two is, you can also see yung feedback between these things if you check them in Glassdoor. So Glassdoor, guys, is a website wherein you can check yung salary, ano ba yung working conditions, or like how, what is the company culture, so on and so forth. So it's one of the things that I look for personally when I start seeking job applications. I want to know, paano ba mag-work sa Wells Fargo, or paano ba mag-work sa gantong company? I want to know. So I want to get feedback towards other people or other employees who have been there or who are currently there. Mga ganun. So the second thing is Reddit. So this is just a personal take for me. I check Reddit because I want to know if ito bang si company na to, okay ba yung benefits, okay ba yung mga ganito, okay ba sila. And that's also one way for you to have an idea and for you to prepare yourself more na, okay, goods dito. So I most likely will probably prepare for it more because I know for a fact this company is good for me. Ganun siya. And then, the next thing is dress appropriately. So this is pretty simple, and I'll also be discussing this in the next slide in a few. But one of the things that people usually see, or recruiters usually say, is that perception is everything. So the moment na makita ka namin, and we see na parang naka-DBTK ka or naka-essentials ka, there's some sort of misalignment when it comes to the interview proper. Why? Because dressing appropriately is also part of the company culture, regardless of wherever you are, because everyone is expected to bring up an image that resonates with the company as well. So dressing appropriately is crucial. So you can definitely lean on towards like polo shirts, long sleeves, polos, anything that has a collar, they're all good. Yun lang siya, guys. So next thing is that you have to come in early. So again, this is sort of a practice then, guys. So if, for example, sa school nyo, you guys are very keen sa attendance, gusto nyo maaga kayo, then you guys are all good. Kasi one of the things na hindi lang siya sa interview, it also speaks character when it comes to how you will be when it comes to work. Why? Because if you come in early, it's always going to be a practice that you have to come in every at least 20 to 30 minutes. Ako, I usually prepare at least an hour or so. I make sure na I'm already all good to go. I'm ready to face the interviewer an hour or so, just because I know for a fact that I still have a lot of things that I can do within that 1 hour time frame, and hindi ako ngarad, right? So, case in point, it's also going to be an indicator of how are you when it comes to work. Kasi again, guys, perception is everything. If you come in, like, let's say, sakto on the dot dun sa oras na yun, recruiters might perceive you as someone who is always on the dot din. But that doesn't necessarily mean that that's the end-all be-all na statement when it comes to you coming in on that specific time frame. It's just a practice then for you guys. So, moving on, we'll be doing the interviews. So, interviews, guys, one of the things na usually people misconceptualize, I guess, is that interviews are scary. At least that's what it was for me. Na if I talk to someone, it feels like nakaka-intimidate sila, or kumbaga HRs or recruiters have to be intimidating. That isn't supposed to be that way. The main goal of interviewers and recruiters in general when they do interviews is to make sure that the interviewee is as comfortable as possible. Why? Because again, guys, ito yung talking stage. So think of it as someone that you're trying to talk to. You're trying to know someone, right? Diba kapag nasa talking stage kayo, guys, you guys are trying to know each other, ano ba yung mga specific likes, common denominators nyo between one another. That's also the same thing there. The difference is, you guys are applying for a job, and we are trying to know more about whether you can be a good fit for us. Ganun lang siya. So, with that, one of the key factors there is, number one, answer in a concise manner. So, hindi naman necessarily na parang one-liners lang, but more of the ability for you to convey your thoughts or express them in a manner wherein nasasagot mo siya ng maayos. So, let's say given the instances I was asked a question, if I'm able to deliver it in a manner wherein we both agree and we both understand each other, then that's all good. Number two is maintain eye contact. Yes, definitely this is for virtual, but again, it's also applicable towards whenever you're in a face-to-face interview. Why? Because maintaining eye contact not only perceives confidence and perceives comfortability, it also perceives na you understand what you are getting into, which is an interview. And the thing there is, if you are not maintaining eye contact towards a recruiter or towards an interviewer, it tells a lot kasi. So that's also relevant to the third slide, which is yung tone, posture, and body language. So if, for example, ganito lang ako na nakatingin lang ako sa baba, or like nakatingin lang ako sa kasame, so on and so forth, it tells the recruiter that I'm not confident enough to land the position here. Or it tells the recruiter that I'm not confident enough to answer your questions. So that could lead into a lot of factors. You could probably say na hindi ako prepared, or we could probably say na baka hindi siya nakapag-prepare, maybe the person is too shy, the person is too awkward, so on and so forth. And again, that also brings back to your prep work, right? So if hindi ka nakapag-prepare, most likely there will be instances like that. But again, guys, you can also play it off as being comfortable and being confident. So, kumbaga, confidence is key when it comes to interviews, because not necessarily overly confident, guys, ha? Baka naman sobrang palumpalo tayo. Pero it's more of trying to make sure na you guys are within the same level of communication between one another, right? So, a little bit of context with that. When I was starting then, again, so like one of the interviews that I had was a group panel interview. So I didn't know the people that I'm going to be with in the interview. And at the same time, I didn't know that it was a group panel interview. So I just came in there with myself and just told to myself that my best skill is English communication, and I'll just gonna use it within the best of my abilities here, because I don't know if the people around me have more experience than me. And I got the job, but not because of I was a fresh grad, or I didn't even have experience. I wasn't even a fresh grad to begin with, but I just used the main resource that I have, which is English communication skills. And that's also the same thing with everyone that's watching. it doesn't necessarily mean that just because this person has more experience than you doesn't mean that you can't land a job. Dahil sa lahat ng companies na pag-a-applyan nyo, there will be people who have more experience than you, than yourself. But the thing is, what do you have that you can bring to the table that they can't? And vice versa. Yung ganun lang siya. And then, be aware of your tone, posture, and body language. Again, guys, if we are not relaxed, if we are nervous, kasi magiginig din sa tone mo, magiginig din sa body language mo, and sa posture. Like, for example, if, again, my example is, if I'm talking to you in a manner which is like this, and I'm not looking at you, a recruiter can read that. A recruiter can see through it na kinakabahan to. Baka, do you need some time for you to prepare? So on and so forth. So, that's about it, right? So, next is going to be the questions that you should ask your interviewer. Now, again, I've mentioned before yung Glassdoor and your Reddit. And this is the cue for that. Now, usually in an interview, they give you a lot of questions, right? And the final question that they will ask you before they wrap things up is, so I'm basically done interviewing you. Do you have any questions for me? Now, most of the time, people would say, no, I'm good. Because of fear that they might get a ping pong question. That a ping pong question basically, guys, is when you ask something, a question gets back at you. But in reality, if you ask, you also have a purview about what's it going to be. Ito ba talaga yung gusto ko? Ito ba talaga yung company na gusto ko? Because of those questions. And the things that you guys should ask there is, number one, what is the company culture? It seems bleak at first, thinking na, paano ako mag-fit in sa culture na to? But in reality, the more that you think about it and the more that you try to embrace it, the more that you understand how company cultures differ towards companies. So, number one is company culture. So, paano ba yung company culture sa inyo? Or like, what's the company culture in your company? If a recruiter says, or if an interviewer says that, oh, we tend to give in collaboration over competition, we like to collaborate with other people, make sure that they have fun in the workplace, and we also emphasize on work-life balance. If those things ping a lot of green flags sa tenga nyo, then this is probably the company that you're looking for. But on the other hand, if they say things that you are not currently looking for, then that's basically something that you should already understand by then, right? Number two is that, what are the opportunities available within the company? Now, this is something na normally you would already know because technically you wouldn't get these questions or you wouldn't be able to ask these questions if you're not getting interviewed yourself. So, if on the event that recruiters ask you for a referral, if you have other people who are interested, then this is the question that you should ask. What are the opportunities available within the company? And also, this could be another thing of interest. Why? Because you would be able to know if this company has long-term progression plans towards their employees. So, for example, let's say ako, when I was still in my early 20s, when I was still working, I tend to ask, paano ba yung career progression dito? How are we able to move towards the next step of the ladder when it comes to getting promotions, so on and so forth? And they give me a specific detail on how to do that. And that's crucial when it comes to fresh graduates because sometimes we wouldn't be able to have an idea kasi, or we wouldn't be able to have a clear view on how these things work. And Knowing that key information helps you build your career pathing. The more that you're able to build your career pathing towards the specific set of progressions that you have, the better that you're going to be at your job. So yun siya, guys. Now, where do you think the company is headed in the next 5 years? Is a question that you ask that explicitly states that you want to stay in this company, and at the same time, you want to know how will be the growth of the company that you're supposedly joining for. So I'll give you an example, guys, for that one. So Wells Fargo, when I asked that, I was told that they have long-term plans. And this is something that I'm interested in because I'm trying to look for a company wherein it's able to give me a lot of curveballs. As much as possible, I want to be in a position wherein there's always something new for me to learn. And that's what Wells Fargo has given me back then, or was stated to me back then when they asked these questions. And I think that's also something that you guys could definitely ask towards your employers or towards the recruiters that you will be talking this with, because it's imperative that you guys know where you're heading to and how are you going to be there, right? Because usually when you get asked this question, where do you see yourself in 5 years? I think I see myself still working here with the position, so on and so forth like that. And you asking these questions as well gives them the perception that you definitely are interested in the role. And that's also something that could potentially be the reason why you will be hired for them. So, yun siya, guys. Next slide, please. So, the next section would be dressing well. Now, when it comes to dressing well, I think I've already mentioned before that collars are a thing. So it's pretty important for us to know and visualize how do we want to perceive ourselves when it comes to interviewers, right? So ako ang go-to ko personally, I just go for polos because number one, they're easy to wear, and also you can fit them in any sort of occasion. So kaya tayo Tito vibes most of the time. So number one is that what you should do is to wear appropriate clothes and shoes. Number two is that pay attention to details. And number three is maintain proper grooming. Now, number one, wear appropriate clothes and shoes. So if the company requires you to do business casual, then you go business casual. If the company is okay with you going casual, then you can go for casual. But not to a certain point, guys, na like I've said before, na magti-t-shirt lang tayo and then something like that. You can do t-shirt with an overshirt na polo panlabas and that's good. But if, for example, let's say it's just a graphic t-shirt and the latter, then that's something that isn't applicable. Kasi the expectation is we are going to be dressed to work. And at the same time, we have to look appropriate, not just for ourselves, but also to maintain the company's image, wherever company that you are applying for and you will be with in the future. So number two is pay attention to details. This specifically means that, huwag lang tayo basta suot, guys. So pupwede naman din na if we wear a polo or if we wear a polo shirt, we make sure that it's ironed well or like it's steamed. Kasi if may mga crinkles in or may mga gusot-gusot yan, then that's also something that is some sort of, not really a red flag, but more of a perception towards you, guys. And then number three is maintain proper grooming. Now, this is the usual wherein your fingernails, so on and so forth, you know, this is completely understandable. Now, the don'ts is say no to loud patterns. That's also number one. Now, loud patterns doesn't necessarily mean na hindi ka pa pwede mag-floral, but just not to a certain point wherein you're the odd one out there. Na litaw na litaw ka. Right? Because even if you don't perceive yourself as distracting, other people might see you like that or might see you as distracting. So again, no to loud patterns. Now, number two is don't over-accessorize. Now, the thing there is, if you do wear a lot of rings, bracelets, necklaces, and the latter, it will look like you're not coming in for work. It looks like you're coming in for a night out. Why? Because, number one, there's no need for you or there's no relevance for the accessories that you have in the workplace. And it will probably be a distraction towards you and others as well. And then number three is never show too much skin. Now, in the modern age, this actually depends. But what the basic understanding is that we should be able to wear what's comfortable for us, but not to a certain level that it will be obscene. Yun na lang siya. Kasi nowadays, especially sa current weather natin, mainit talaga, guys. So, imposible na. We are not going to be doing that. But at the same time, we also have to maintain the level of decency that, again, we are not distracting or we are not able to destroy the reputation of the company that you're currently working in. So, just to wrap it up, basically, when it comes to interviews, guys, one of the things that you guys have to make sure lang is project yourself in a manner wherein comfortable ka. Okay lang nakabahan ka, but also make sure na yung kaba mo is ginagamit mo in a way for you to set things off for you properly. Kasi, again, interviews are more of nakikipag-usap lang kayo sa recruiter. You guys are trying to know the person and that interview is trying to know you in a level of way that would determine the opportunity that you will have in that certain company. Yun lang, guys. Thanks so much for listening. And I'm definitely ready to hear your guys' thoughts about it.
Alright, so nakakamit pala ako, sir. Alright, so thank you so much, Sir Jason. No? So, sir, okay lang pa ba yung internet connection ko? Kasi naglalag ako kanina.
Yeah, you're connected.
Ah, okay po. Sige. Alright, so students, the floor is now open for questions. So, sir, may questions kami kanina na applicable siya for sa topic na ito. Alright, so we have from Gilrea. What are the consequences of lying on a resume about experiences or skills?
Well, one thing is that hindi naman siya necessarily consequences, but more of it's going to be the reason why you would probably not get hired. Kasi in this modern age, like, companies already have specific set of standards, requirements na they will be able to determine whether you're lying on your resume or not. And especially about experiences. So, sa experience kasi, let's say that you get the job. But once you're in the certain workplace setting, people will definitely figure that out. Na, wait lang, parang wala siyang specific na idea dito. Mga ganun. And, kumbaga, it's not something that's game-changing or kumbaga parang end of the world type view, but it's more of the image kasi personally. If you come into a place where you don't have the necessary experience for it yet you were able to land it, diba? It's a lot of dominoes in effect. So yun lang siya.
Okay, so thank you, sir. We have another question, sir, from Miss Karina po. So what is the perception of an interviewer towards a tattooed interviewee? So is there still a stigma about applicants with tattoos?
Actually, that depends on the company. So in the current setting naman kasi, there are a lot of companies who don't necessarily mind tattoos. Again, it's with the company or it's with the position that you're applying for. If it's the usual traditional na companies. And I'm pretty sure one way or another you guys will discover that there will be stigmas about it and there will be companies who will not be comfortable with people who have tattoos. But there is still a majority of companies or there's a huge majority of companies who wouldn't mind that because at the end of the day, what matters to them is the level of productivity or the level of output that you can supply them with. And I think that's what matters then personally. Kasi it doesn't matter if you have tattoos as much as possible, because if kaya mo namang buhatin yung sarili mo, if kaya mong dalhin yung sarili mo sa work, then what's it for us, diba?
All right. So thank you so much, sir. We have another question po. So, san ba yun? All right. So the question po, sir, is what interview question do job applicants have the most difficulty answering?
I think that tell me about your. So usually when people ask, especially sa akin before when I was asked about tell me about you, or when I usually people would say na parang hi, my name is Claude, I am a blah blah blah, and I like to do I like to watch Netflix, so on and so forth. But in reality, what people or what recruiters want to hear is that hi, my name is Claude Yñigo Barreras, I am currently a fresh graduate student. I have been previously active with so on and so forth, and blah 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 and blah blah blah. So basically, what that tells you guys, or ang key takeaway sa pagsagot ng tell me about yourself, it isn't necessarily about you. It's about the achievement, the things that you have already been doing. If, like Ma'am Vera mentioned earlier, if you have the time to upskill, try to mention that. If you have already upskilled, also bring that, and also bring the things that you have already completed before, because it will definitely help you improve the chances of winning or improve the chances of you getting the position you're applying for.
All right. So thank you so much, sir. So we have another question po. So is it okay if we ask how much salary will be during the job interview?
Yes, definitely. As is, you're right, man. But is at the there be certain there will be certain situations where they will tell you right off the bat, meaning that they only know these things if you have an interview or if you're already on your final interview. Doon mo lang siya malalaman. Kaya nga what I specifically suggest that definitely do it yourself. You can look at Glassdoor, at other forums, and you can have an idea about how much yung ballpark or how much are we expecting ba sa company. And that's also something that I do actually, kasi so when I started here at Wells Fargo, there was expectation or there was this POV na ibang level na company na, so on and so forth, and I had to research, you know, how much would it be, just so I can have a detailed benchmark on like what is the safe offer or what is the offer that I can ask. And that's also something that you guys can ask too, and you guys can research as well.
Okay, so we have another question po, sir. So how should we reply to questions that seem too personal during an interview?
Okay. So when it comes to that, I think that's where being one up, that would be. But because if the question seem appropriate for you guys, or if sounds inappropriate, then you also have the right as an interviewee to decline the question. But hindi dapat lahat, guys, ha? Baka naman mamaya lahat ng tanong sa inyo. I think that's... So, if you feel like it, that's something that recruiters won't invalidate you naman, supposedly. And the best way for you to answer that is, I think that this is that I am not comfortable to this. Ganun lang.
Okay, so guys, so we have we are a bit over time, so I'll be reading two questions na lang for sir, kasi it's lunchtime na rin. Okay, sir, Here we have... Ito po, sir. So, I'm still contemplating whether or not to take the board exam after graduation, pursue a master's degree, or apply for a job straight away. So, ano po yung masuggest niyo po? So, would you give me?
Actually, I think we kind of have the same route back then. So, when I graduated from psychology, one of the things that I considered was to take the psychometrician exam, to go master's, or to get a job right away. What I initially did was habang wini-wait ko yung grades ko sa thesis, or while when na-confirm ko ng grades ko sa thesis ko or sa final grades namin, saka ako nag-apply. The reason why is because if you're like me, na hindi naman tayo binayaan, syempre, I have to grind for that myself. Now, my perspective there is, I can definitely juggle these things at once. I just need to know the task prioritization or my time management skills. And the thing there is, everything there between the three is all good. Walang tama o mali sa magiging decision mo. It just depends on ano ba yung gusto mong mangyari in the future. Gusto mo ba ng maagang career progression? Then, you start a job right away. If gusto mo ng dagdag na bala kapag nag-apply ka ng trabaho and a certain skip level dahil may master's ka, then go for master's. If you want to go for a specific line of work that would include or would involve board certification, then you go for boards. Again, it definitely depends on which path you would be. Kaya nga, very crucial yung pag-research about the companies and so on and so forth. It's because that way, you can have an idea ano ba talaga yung career path mo? Ano ba yung gusto mong gawin in the future? And, like, for example, sa akin, I took the corporate route because for me, I think this is where I belong. I was supposed to go and take my med school for being a psychiatrist or a psychologist, but I did not go back there because of the reason na mas nakita ko yung purpose. Ganun siya.
Alright. So, nakadepende talaga, sir, kung ano yung gusto mong abutin as of the time being talaga. Yeah. So, sir, for our last question po, what advices do you have for graduating students who will be looking for jobs with other applicants who graduate from other colleges at the same time? So, especially if the other candidates come from big or top schools.
Don't be afraid. That's number one. Don't be afraid because number one, hindi naman yan nakadepende sa kung saan sila nanggaling. At the end of the day, ang nakadepende dyan is ano ba yung kaya mong ipakita sa kanila versus sa kanila. Kasi I know that this is something that's always going to be a question. Galing silang dasal eh. Galing silang RNA. Ganun. And the thing there is if they land on an application the same as you are, then, and you know that they came from these schools, then write on how you can show them that you're better than them, or that you're the better qualified applicant for them. Because, truth be told naman, that will always happen kasi. So, it just depends on, number one, how you project yourself, how you apply yourself in the interviews, and also how you showcase your skills. One of the things din pala na I forgot to mention is that bukod sa talking stage, ang interviews is also all about selling yourself to the highest bidder, the company, right? If you're able to sell yourself enough or quite enough to a certain level na magugustuhan ka nila, regardless kahit saang school yan, regardless kung ano yung specific na skills na meron sila, basta na ipakita mo sa kanila na you're deserving of that role, then they will take you. Ganun siya.
Okay. So, yan naman, sir, na don't be intimidated by the status of the school kasi yung easy sell mo naman is yung self mo.
Yes.
Alright. So, that would be all, sir, for our question and answer portion. And I'd like to thank you so much, sir, for answering the questions and for presenting to us the virtual interview tips.
All right. Guys.
Yes, sir. So I wish you a very good day and happy lunch po, sir. Kasi lunch time. Okay, yeah. Sir. Thank you, sir. Bye, sir. All right. So thank you, Sir Jason, for thank you, Sir Claude, for joining us today and for showing us or for giving us tips on virtual interviews. So we wish to have you on our next set of webinars. And if you are interested in applying a job at Wells Fargo, so you send your applications on www.jobson80.com/Wells Fargo. All right. So all I can say is if this was my first time attending webinars like this, this would really help me in looking for jobs. So to our audience, thank you so much for attending, and we hope that you have we hope that what you have learned here today will be useful to you in your journey of work, your journey to the world of work. And if you have any additional questions, don't hesitate to send us a message on our Facebook page, facebook.com/jobson80.com, or email us at info@jobson80.com. All right, so to give us the closing remarks, may we invite Ms. Ludivinia A. Alonzo, RGC RPM, and the Supervising Guidance Counselor of Arellano, Juan Sumulong Campus.
Hi, Chips. It is again another day of inspiring webinar to equip you with necessary information, and this time as part of preparation for your future career. I know you are all looking forward to your graduation day, especially the fourth-year students here. However, what comes with your excitement is a question on your mind as to how to land on your respective dream job. With the expertise of our guest speakers today, and of course, with the effort of jobs180.com, I am pretty sure that you learned a lot from today's talk. Let us give our guest speakers a hearty welcome. Thank you for sharing your time with us this morning. It is quite doubtful to look at the future and remain positive in getting your most wanted career. You keep on thinking on how to develop new skills that will be more impressive to employers and make yourself saleable. You must try to present yourself in the best way possible. With the topics that are discussed by our speakers, I would like to assume that somehow you have important takeaways to be able to reach your ultimate goal. Just keep your focus, keep believing in yourself that you can always do it, and do not ever stop whenever there is a challenge ahead, because there is always a sunlight after a dark cloud. Thanks so much, everyone, for learning with us this morning. God bless you all.
All right. So thank you so much, Ms. Alonzo, for that wonderful closing remarks. So guys, a bit of an intermission or infomercial. So have you been manifesting to reach your hashtag career goals this 2024. So don't worry, because in Accenture, we got you. So join our one-day hiring event on April 17, 2024, and be part of our amazing data entry and accounting teams here at Accenture. All right, so just scan the QR code presented in your screen, or you can visit the link below to register. So what are you waiting for? So scan the QR code and be part of Accenture, where we work at the heart of change. All right, so there you have it, guys. We are done with the talk proper and successfully tackled all the topics for today's session. So do not forget to evaluate this event. The link is flashed on your screen. You can also scan the QR code, and is also available at the comment section. All right, so thank you so much for attending and staying throughout the event. And we would like to thank Ms. Karina for the hard work and coordination in making this event a success. So your dedication and efforts were instrumental, and we are truly grateful for everything you have done. So we hope that we have imparted insightful things that would help you as you embark on your journey to the world of work. So please watch out for the next set of webinars we are going to host for, and do not forget to check our Facebook page, and do not hesitate to join for our future sessions. So jobson80.com is looking for interns. So for those of you who are interested, you can submit your resume link at jobson80.com/jobson80 or you may email us at info@jobson80.com. So in conclusion, I want to leave you with this thought. So your career is a journey and each day is an opportunity to build your path to success. So take what you have learned today and use it as a stepping stone to reach your goals. So remember, the key to a successful career is continuous learning, resilience, and a passion for what you do. So go out there and pursue your dreams and make a difference. So thank you so much for joining us today and I wish you all the best in your career building endeavor. So the program has been concluded. This is your host, Yumi, and we will see you soon and have a great day. So don't forget, guys, to bring your umbrellas because it is very hot today in the Philippines. All right, and eat your lunch. Thank you so much and have a great day.
Constantly changing world where businesses move at a rapid pace. Innodata solves the toughest challenges in any industry. Through human expertise and the power of technology, we are a community that thrives on a culture of collaboration, ideation, and innovation. And we want you to be part of our family. Your journey towards a meaningful and thriving career begins with us. Be part of the Inno community. We are Innodata.
In Makati Medical Center, your well-being does not stop. We promote a healthy normal by complying with 100% safety protocols in our facilities. With world-class service and operational excellence, we ensure that Makati Med meets the global healthcare standards of JCI. No matter the nature of your visit, your health is our priority. So you are always safe in Makati Med, the hospital with a heart.
At a time when customers are demanding more value more rapidly, you need a transformation partner that can help make your customer experience your competitive differentiator. For years, RRD Go has been helping companies reinvent how they do business and reimagine how customers connect with their brand. Our customized solutions, deep industry expertise, and highly skilled global talent pool empower clients across every industry. We elevate customer engagement with targeted, interactive, and compelling omni-channel communications, and leverage tech-driven solutions to reimagine customer interactions and accelerate your transformation agenda. Our digital and workflow solutions generate actionable insights, enhance organizational flexibility, and simplify transactions. We harness the power of next-level technologies to bring new solutions to life. Everything from automation and data visualization to AI, AR, and beyond. By combining best-in-class, forward-looking technologies with some of the industry's best forward-thinking minds, we can help take your customer experience beyond what you thought was possible. Discover how. Visit rrd.com/go today.
Ever notice how a smile is contagious? It's hard not to smile when someone's smiling at you. Go ahead, try it. We'll wait. Smiling yet? Us too. Here at T-Tech, we love smiles. In fact, we've built a culture around them and a brand on top of them. For us, it's all about the feeling you get when someone goes that extra smile to brighten your day. It's how an upside-down frown makes our T-Tech world go round. Our mission is to make the whole world smile, and it starts with you. We focus on what matters most to you. Career growth, personal development, well-being, whatever it may be. It's all part of the T-Tech experience. So put on a smile. Come join us and let's change the world, one smile at a time.
Thank you.